missions are a reflection of who we are as a people in the eyes of the world. And it's only when these missions are properly taken care of that investors will build confidence to come in and invest. You can only go to a place where you think investments will boom. Mr. Speaker, in the course of our jobs in the last assembly, in the 8th assembly, we went through some of the missions. I will start with the one in New York. When you go to the New York Nigerian House, you meet a workforce that is not properly motivated. You meet a workforce that is disgruntled. I'm sorry to use that word, but that is what they have. As a government official, they hardly receive you with open arms because they feel we are not doing enough for them, especially when you are from the parliament. Mr. Speaker, if you go to the New York Nigerian House, it's a vast building of so many floors, but only 3 floors are being occupied and looking seriously dilapidated. The work condition, once you see, you know, tells you of what Nigeria is down here in Nigeria. If you go to Cote d'Ivoire, Mr. Speaker, I've been there too. The same story. And our ambassadors there are always lamenting. In Malaysia, the story is the same. While we are in a rented apartment close to school buildings, which expose them to public attack anytime, and knowing what our people are exposed to in Malaysia, with all the myriad of problems and all our people in the various prisons, our mission is exposed to the public and they are not properly catered for. In the UAE, Abu Dhabi, the story is the same. All over the world, the story is the same. So I will only support my neighbor by saying that as a parliament, especially now that we are in a budget session, to try and convince the executive so that we make budgetary provision for our mission, because they are our reflection. What they are is what the world sees us as. They represent us outside. They are Nigeria outside of Nigeria. They fly our flag. So it's only when they are properly taken care of that investors will have confidence to come in. We need investors to come in. Let us properly fund our mission so that they will truly represent Nigeria and truly encourage investors to come into Nigeria to invest. Thank you, Mr. Speaker, for allowing me to speak on this matter.